Cool. What's up, tubers? Devin here with Make Anything, and in my last video, I used this little laser engraver to make some cool dice, as well as a laser banana. And I asked you guys for suggestions of other things that I could laser engrave, so I figured why not just jump back on it, make a follow-up video, and laser some more cool stuff that you guys requested. Pretty much everything that I'm gonna be engraving today with this machine is not recommended or advised in any way. It's a bad idea. But at the same time, I can't stop you. Make your own stupid mistakes. Don't blame me. One of the things that a lot of you wanted to see was some lasered toast, some steak, other lasered foods. So I decided, why not make a whole meal out of it? That's right, so I'm lasering a bunch of different ingredients, and hopefully some of it will taste edible. Let's see. All right, so here is test subject number one. I'm using sourdough bread because it's nice and white, so it should create good contrast with the lasered bits. And I also just like sourdough for my grilled cheese sandwiches. Thanks to my 3D printed macro camera mount, I'm able to get these really cool close-up shots, and we can see how the laser is actually etching into the toast. You can also see how much height variation there is in the toast, and that's what led to some detail being lost. So you can see it came out pretty good, but the tips of two of these triangles are missing because of that height variation. So I decided to try again after making the toast a little more flat. Who doesn't like a nice thumb massage for their toast? I also significantly increased the carving time, which should leave a darker mark. Sure enough, this attempt led to a much cleaner result. So toast works, but what about the other ingredients? We're gonna have a pretty simple sandwich, just some ham and cheese, but first I'm gonna cut these into rectangles, that way it's easier to fit them under the laser. When focusing the laser on the cheese, I could tell it was semi-translucent, which led to the light being dispersed a bit. And even at a really high power, the most it did was slightly melt the cheese. Not a very impressive effect. So I switched to the ham, and I just used a tissue paper to try to dry off all the moisture. And clearly the results were much better than they were with the cheese. In the close-up, you can see it's getting nice and roasted. And it also explains why you don't want to stick your hand under the laser. As you can see, I laser etched a little homage to the cute little piggy that sacrificed itself for this sandwich. All right, at this point, I just wanted to explore, so I threw a carrot under the laser, because, you know, we need some sides to go with the sandwich. And what's better than a bunny made out of a carrot? A great way to get your kids to eat their vegetables. Up next, I tried a cracker, and it worked really well, even with a really short burn time. It's wheat-based and relatively flat, so it makes a really good surface to laser engrave. I also wanted to test out the grayscale option, so I tried etching my face onto one of the crackers. I call this white cracker on a whole wheat cracker. My first attempt was too light, the second too dark, and even once it was fine-tuned, it was not the most recognizable image. Maybe that's best reserved for paper. We have the ingredients, so now it's time to make the sandwich. Just gotta add a little bit of butter, throw that into the pan, add the little piggy. As you can see, it's pretty dried out by now. And since the cheese didn't engrave, I just cut it into this weird pattern. I like to throw a lid halfway on the pan to melt that cheese without losing the crispiness of the sandwich. Yep, I bet you didn't think you'd get cooking advice from this channel. And honestly, I don't think I should be giving cooking advice. But hey, there it is. My expertly crafted collection of laser-cut culinary creations.
Alright guys, well, this very well may be the meal of the future. And if it is, I'm pretty happy to live in the present. But I am pretty hungry. I've been working on this sandwich all day. So, why not have a taste? I mean, the logo obviously does taste like severely burnt toast. Kind of makes me glad that that's the maximum size for this laser engraver. But the rest of the sandwich is great. All right, let's try the carrots. Tastes like carrots. These crackers smell kind of bad. So, yeah, I'm definitely not having the dark one. I'll just have these two. Okay, well, now I can say with certainty, laser engraving your food may look cool, but it tastes awful. Now, on top of lasering different foods, there were two other things that a lot of you wanted to see. One was to see if I could laser engrave a 3D print. Of course, 3D prints are just plastic. This thing isn't made to etch plastic, and I figured it would just melt. So instead of just using your regular old PLA, I decided to try out Timberfill by Filament One, which is a wood-based filament. I figured if any filament is gonna have a chance at showing a laser etched design, it would be a wood filament. So here's that Timberfill printing on my replicator. And as you can see, it's got a very interesting texture. Kind of reminds me of cereal. And unfortunately, it's about as strong as cereal as well. And it also sticks to the build plate really well. Two properties that don't exactly go together so wonderfully. But I figured I could still try one side, so I went ahead and gave it a shot. My first pass was a little too weak, so I strengthened the laser, and then I was actually getting some darkening. But as you can see, it was also burning all the way through the plastic. Of course, that could be resolved by printing thicker layers, so this isn't entirely unfeasible. Not that the end result was particularly stunning, but it's definitely not nothing. And the last thing that I got a lot of requests for was to stick my hand under the laser engraver and see if I can tattoo myself. Well, I really appreciate the curiosity, but I'm not about to burn my flesh with a laser. But it doesn't mean I won't still do something pretty stupid to entertain you. So, instead of etching my hand, I decided I'm gonna try to etch my thumbnail. See? Still pretty stupid, still pretty entertaining. I'm kind of terrified, so let's see what happens. The first thing I did was print out this little jig that would hold my thumb in place underneath the laser. It's printed in a nice red Matter Hackers Pro PLA, perfect for hiding the blood stains that might result from this experiment. I glued some neoprene to the bottom for grip, and then I installed it on my laser, pretty much the same way I installed the dice holder in my last video. I just rotated everything 90 degrees so that the laser would be moving more than the build plate. After that, it was go time. Yeah, I didn't last very long, but I decided to try lowering the power of the laser a bit, just to give it a wholehearted effort. And I withstood it as long as I possibly could, but it just kept getting hotter until I couldn't bear it. And for all that, not even a mark. So, I guess it turns out they tell you not to stick your hand under the laser for a reason. Even with the laser at a pretty weak setting, and without it actually showing anything on my finger, it really freaking burns. What a surprise. So, don't do that. I'm not gonna tell you not to laser a banana or a piece of toast, because it's kinda awesome. I won't tell you to do it, but I won't tell you not to do it. All I will tell you is if you do it, do it in a well-ventilated area. And finally, I know you guys will give me crap if I don't even try it, so I'm gonna take a bite of this cracker of death. Bon appetit. All right, guys, well, there you have it. That's what it's like when you stick some weird stuff under a laser. I guess if you wanna comment on more stupid stuff I can burn with a laser, feel free. It might be a while, though. I don't feel quite up to the task of eating more badly burnt foods. Alright, well, that's enough stupid stuff for today. So until next time, I'm Devin. This has been Make Anything. Don't forget to stay inspired.